back to G-Tech Productions, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Lego Star Wars 2000, 7190, I think, Millennium Falcon. And the first thing I'm going to review is the inside. Well, never mind the outside. I really like all the printed pieces. Every single piece that has decoration on there is printed. Even the side pieces, there's zero stickers in the set. Yep, zero stickers. And it has a little turret up here. Yeah, where they can shoot down TIE fighters. They have the satellite here. I think the piece is kind of expensive. And now I'm going to review the inside. Okay. The coloring on the inside isn't exactly right because there's a lot of blue and green, especially at the outside of the ship. But here they have where it's like checkers for Star Wars, maybe. And they have a escape pod where you can just slide a figure into. And now you have some storage right here. I can't see. You have some storage right here where you can put some blasters and lightsabers. And right here you have a backpack and a blaster. And now with right here. And here there's a piece that has a printed thing, the Rebel Alliance. I don't want to touch it because it breaks easily. And you also have old cannons on the right and the left. And they have these printed, I don't know what these pieces are, but they're printed. And I guess these are lights to see. Kind of like when Obi-Wan Kenobi and Jane Doffett go through the asteroid. Kind of like that, maybe. But in my opinion, this is a pretty good set. Whoever's watching this, if you want to get this set, I would try to get it used without the instructions, because I would use free online instructions on Lego.com, where you can see it a lot easily. So yeah, that is a review of this Lego Star Wars set. Goodbye.